editor, I'm holding in my hands three of your monographs: Wave Genome, 1994, Wave Genetic Code, 1997, and Linguistic Wave Genome, 2009. What is the principal difference between your theory of wave genetics and the theory of classical genetics? And what is the practical application of your theory?
The difference is as follows. Classical genetics considers the genetic material only as a substance, while we consider it from the point of view of mental constructs. That is, genetic material is a substance that has meanings. These meanings are realized through texts, and this is not a metaphor. These are real texts. DNA are holograms, and this is also not a metaphor. Chromosomes are creating some holographic continuum. And third, the genetic information is defined by quantum non-locality. We artificially create these electromagnetic and acoustic fields, or vice versa, read them directly from chromosomes. This allows us to intentionally influence man, as nobody else is capable of doing now, including medical professionals or biochemists. And as a result of transmitting these wave structures upon man in the form of electromagnetic fields, man can grow up a new kidney, a new liver, a new pancreas, new blood vessels, etc. That is, we can now practically regenerate organs and tissues of man. We have started with animals and now apply this technology to humans. Heavy cases of viral diseases, heavy incurable genetic disorders, all these are cured by the linguistic wave genetics. We do already have cases of practical applications. For example, viruses can be killed in a completely different way without application of any chemical drugs. We can also treat genetic mutations. In 2010, Nobel laureate Luc Montagnier undertook the transmission of the wave phantom of DNA from one water tube, which contained DNA, to the water tube, which didn't contain DNA. For how long were similar experiments ahead of the experiments by Luc Montagnier? And why is your technology more advanced than the technology of Luc Montagnier? We were ahead of the group of Luc Montagnier precisely for 10 years, because in 2000 we staged a crucial experiment on a much higher level than the one of Luc Montagnier, when we transmitted the information from the pancreas upon rats, which didn't have pancreas. We killed their pancreas with the Ellison poison. This is a so-called Ellison model of diabetes. Those poor rats without pancreas were dying, and we transmitted information read by the laser upon these sick rats. But this was not the radiation of a laser. We used the secondary radiation. This procedure was based upon the theory of localized light, and these rats recovered. Luc Montagnier used the information about the DNA segment consisting of 110 pairs of nucleotides, while we transmitted a huge amount of genetic information, and more precisely, morphogenetic information, which allows sick animals to regenerate the absent pancreas and survive. We can compare the genetic information about pancreas with the information about the building of the Moscow University with professors and students, while Luc Montagnier transmitted information from the segment of a text. And the difference between the group of Montagnier and us lies not just in the theoretical explanation, but also in the technical side of experiment. And this difference is crucial, And that is why, while his data is convincing, it concerns only a small portion of the possibility for transmitting the genetic information. Their equipment is very primitive. They simply use some generator, which produces a 7 Hz electromagnetic field, and this is enough to read the genetic information. On our side, we have used a more sophisticated equipment based upon the fact that our chromosomes are the sources of a coherent, that is, laser field. Since it is a laser field, we have decided to create a system which would model this field of a chromosome laser. And so we have used a laser that produces a specific wavelength, which is used by our chromosomes, a red wavelength. We have used a helium neon laser, but a special one. It has a special polarized field. And that is why we were a success of reading not simply a DNA segment, as it was done by Luc Montagnier. We were capable of reading a huge amount of information about pancreas as a whole. And so our foundations, both theoretical and experimental, were more advanced. And we have achieved better results being ahead of Luc Montagnier for 10 years. Tell in more detail about your successful experiments in Toronto in 2001 and 2002. You have treated a chemically induced diabetes in rats via the transferal of the genetic information. It was read from the wholesome organ of a pancreas of a newly born rat of a given genetic line. Also, please discuss the other part of the experiment concerning the transferal of the genetic information from one genetic line upon the other genetic line of a given bacterium. Our experiments were reproduced by the Canadian research group, which was supposed to independently verify our results. In principle, our results are sensational. We had 4 groups of rats, each one with 15 rats. Canadians did everything except for the major procedure. We were responsible for the major procedure, which consisted in operating the laser. Everything else was done by Canadians. The shortest distance for the transferal of the genetic information was 1 centimeter. We have transmitted the laser beam right upon the paw of a rat, though it is important to point out that not the beam itself is the carrier of the genetic information, but the secondary field. But the laser beam was present. We had both the laser beam that transmits the genetic information and the secondary electromagnetic field. We have transmitted the genetic information upon 15 rats. The second group of rats was located in the other room, 3-4 meters away, also 15 rats. We have transmitted the genetic information upon these rats as well, via the secondary electromagnetic field, which was coded by pancreas. That is, it was containing the genetic information about pancreas. The same way we have transmitted the genetic information upon the other groups of rats, each with 15 rats, but after taking them apart into the different locations in Toronto, 15-20 kilometers from the place of the experiment. After Canadians had processed all the data, blood tests, blood sugar levels, they discovered that all the animals had survived, while animals in the control group had died. Animals could have survived only in the case of the pancreas regeneration. Blood sugar in these rats, sick with diabetes, had fallen from a very high level to a normal level. And we proceeded to the second part of the experiment, which was not less significant.
we had chosen two lines of some specific bacterium. One line was insensitive to a very strong antibiotic, and we were a success of transferring the genetic quality of sensitivity to this antibiotic. As a result, we had transformed the insensitive line of bacterium into the line which is sensitive to the antibiotic. Our technologies are patented and everybody can use them. Let us move in this direction. In this way, we can use correctly vast financial resources which are spent now for the research in this direction. Secondly, we would protect humankind from the non-sanctioned use of the linguistic wave genetics. Tell us about your last discovery concerning the programming of stem cells via wave genetics. We have created a technology, which is in fact a discovery. It consists in the wave or quantum control over stem cells. We can record some specific genetic information upon stem cells. We can program them. We can transform them into competent cells, so that we get a desired specific type of city differentiation. We order a stem cell to become a muscle cell, a nerve cell, a bone cell, etc. Medical professionals and biologists cannot do this at this point. Now they will be able to do this. 75% of patients cannot get stem cell therapy for many reasons. First of all, it is not possible to always find a donor. Secondly, even after stem cells are attained, biologists do not know how to manage and control stem cells. They inject them and get cancer as a result. Contrary to this, we have specific technologies which allow us to get own stem cells from a patient, program these stem cells and inject them back.